Why did Mexican revolutionary Pancho Villa have to wait for the light? There he is, Pancho Villa.
Yeah, well, he had to wait till the banks were open before he could rob them.
Well, Pancho Villa was part of a war in Mexico.
He was. Yeah, he was a great, yes. Quite a tremendous stature, but now reduced to a chain of tawdry Mexican restaurants where suburban bimbos go and drink margaritas for $2 a pitcher and
that's it.
Weep into their guacamole.
This is why you didn't get that gig in advertising. Yeah.
But there was a three-part war. There was the government of Mexico against two revolutionaries, Pancho Villa and...
Is it Zapata?
Zapata, yes, the other one. Shoe, I think, in Mexican, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah, in Spanish.
Whereas Pancho Villa means house of Pancho.
Yes,
he wasn't called Pancho Villa, was he? He took his name from his granddad, which is the best name I've ever heard, which is...
Aston.
Aston Villa. Perfect. Jesus, Jesus Villa, which just sounds like the Pope's holiday home. Yeah. Where we go to?
Jesus Villa.
Jesus Villa, yeah.
It so happened that the American public were rather fascinated by this Mexican War, and different American film companies paid the different sides for the rights to film their battles. And Pancho Villa got 20% of the box office of the mutual film company who were on his side, as it were, but he had to wait until the cameras were set up and the light was right before he could begin the battle. And they made him dress up in a general's uniform. Usually he went casual, but they made him dress up in a general's uniform to look like that.
So just before they charged, did they get makeup and everything?
Yeah, wasn't quite that bad, but it was an extraordinary, bizarre war run for American studios. And the strange thing is that actually the reality wasn't that exciting, and they would reenact it back in America to make it look more bloody and dramatic. But they would use the footage of him, you know, pointing in his uniform.
Because lots of the Mexican revolutionaries sort of operated as bandits as well, didn't they?
Yeah.
They were sort of political armies, but they were bandits to raise money for their armies. And he held up a train, and he took 122 silver ingots and a bank employee, a Wells Fargo bank employee, hostage, and then forced Wells Fargo to help him sell the ingots with the hostage.
Good.
It's fantastically
very good.
I can't cope with two intelligent, interesting people on this show.
It's good, isn't it?
Yeah, it's very hard.
He didn't just say 120, it was 122. Yeah. I like that.
But it sticks with you.
Scholarly of you. Very impressive. We said on QI, we told you what Pancho Villa's last words were. I don't know if you remember, Alan, you were definitely there.
Turn the lights out.
Ouch.
No, don't let it end like this. Let me at least say something. Was apparently...
But
we've since discovered that this may be a myth because his car was hit by 40 bullets and he himself by 9 dum-dum bullets, so he was probably killed instantly and said nothing. Mm. But I like the idea of someone being disappointed that they didn't have any last words to say.
Maybe it was reverse.
Yeah. Don't park here.
Tell them I said something was his supposed last words.
But...
Yeah.